Okay, let's look at number 9. Two balls are on a frictionless horizontal table. Ball X moves at 10 meters per second as shown, then collides elastically with identical ball Y, which is initially at rest. After the collision, the ball X moves at 6 meters per second along a path of 53 degrees to its original direction as shown here. Which of the following diagrams best represents the motion of the ball Y after the collision? So with this one, it is elastic, but I'm mostly going to focus on the conservation of momentum aspect. Okay? Now, remember, we have both momentum in the X direction here, right? This is moving along the X direction, but also in the Y direction. This comes off the Y direction. Okay? So we can kind of do something we've done similar, where we're splitting the X's and the Y's. Okay? Remember, the initial momentum in the Y direction is what? Zero, right? Because this is not moving in the Y direction at all, just in the X direction, and then this is not moving at all, right? So I've had zero equals, so this X, right? So I have something like, I need to find the momentum in this direction, right? Now they're identical balls, so if I have M, V, F, or I'll put MVX for the X ball, plus MVY. I know that these M's are going to cancel because they're the same number, right? And so that will actually cancel out with this zero here. Okay, so this just equals VX plus VY, and then VX, the velocity of this in the Y direction, right here. So that will be what? 6. Right, sine and cosine, so this one's sine, this is y, sine 53 plus dy. Okay. So I'm looking for 6 sine 53. We can go ahead and get a number for that. 1 second, let me grab a calculator. We have 6 times sine 53, so this gives me 4.8. Okay? So this is going to be a negative 4.8, in other words, it's saying it's down, right? So we can actually also, we know it's going down, right? So we can also eliminate B and A right off the bat because those are not going down, okay? Now, we also want to look at the X direction. So we have our PI equals PF. So this is MVX equals MVX. And VY. Now all the M's are the same, so they all go away. So I have 10 equals this component, right? That X component. So that will be 6 cosine 53 plus VY, which is what I'm trying to solve here. So it'll just be 10 minus 6 cosine 53 equals VY. And so VY will equal, let me grab a calculator again. VY equals 6.4. Okay? So what I'm looking for is something that matches up with this. So I have 4.8 down, and then I have 6.4 across. Well, it can't be C, because my magnitude here is smaller than either one of those numbers. So that doesn't make sense, okay? Now, the Y direction here is, sorry, the X direction, this is my X direction, is bigger than my Y direction, right? This is bigger. So I need to have a bigger X direction, and so that would be D, right? This part right here, that's going to be bigger than this part right here.